Here begins Smurfs Tale Collection 6, narrated by John Hastings for Saga Egmont. The Smurfbox Derby. Today, the Smurfs are repairing the mill. They have to push a wagon full of heavy building materials all the way to their village.
"Perhaps one day wagons will Smurf all by themselves,"
Poet moans.
"That's a Smurfly interesting idea,"
Handy says to himself. He hides behind a tall palisade and gets to work. Weeks go by, and then, one beautiful morning, the door to his workshop opens. The Smurfs are surprised to see a strange, roaring vehicle in front of them.
"That's the first Smurfmobile," Handy announces proudly. "If you want, I can make such vehicles for all of you."
"I want one,"
Smurfette says happily.
"Me too! Me too!"
the other Smurfs call together.
"My friends, please!"
Brainy interrupts them.
"Papa Smurf should Smurf his vehicle first." "Thank you,"
Papa Smurf says,
"but I Smurf only my own feet."
"You're absolutely right,"
says Hefty approvingly.
"The invention will make lazy Smurfs out of you."
Soon, the Smurfmobile craze starts to spread like wildfire. More and more vehicles appear in the village, and one is stranger than the other. Meanwhile, in the forest, the evil wizard Gargamel also has a problem related to transport. He is trying to pull a heavy pile of wood all the way to his cottage. Suddenly, a Smurfmobile zooms past him.
"Hey, nasty wizard, try to Smurf us,"
the passengers call out. As Azrael tries in vain to catch the Smurfmobile, Gargamel starts to think. The traffic in the village quickly increases, and soon the first multi-vehicle collision occurs.
"I knew these machines would Smurf us nothing but trouble,"
Hefty says.
"There is nothing wrong with progress,"
Brainy replies.
"But we should Smurf some driving regulations."
Brainy writes down the rules of the road and reads them out loud to all the drivers. Then he positions himself at the crossroads and starts to control the traffic.
"You're causing danger, clumsy Smurf,"
he calls out suddenly.
"I have to Smurf you a caution."
But as he raises his eyes from his notebook, he sees a horrible traffic jam blocking the crossroads. The furious drivers start yelling at each other.
"Smurf this piece of junk out of my way,"
one of them says.
"What? My Smurfmobile is 100 times better than your useless banger,"
the other one replies. Brainy Smurf tries to calm the situation.
"Let's Smurf a big race to find out which Smurfmobile is the best,"
he suggests. In the meantime, Gargamel creates his own machine, a steamroller to smash the Smurfs flat. The vehicle is designed to be powered by Big Mouth the Giant.
"Come in, my friend,"
the wizard says to him.
"I have a delicious meal for you."
Gargamel lowers a pot of stew through a hatch in the machine's roof. Big Mouth, who is not very clever, starts to run on the treadmill, trying to reach the food. The heavy vehicle starts off. Gargamel heads towards the hill and soon discovers a racetrack bordered by small flags.
This looks promising,"
he sniggers. At this very moment, Brainy waves his flag. Smurfmobiles start off in a cloud of dust, and the race begins. Suddenly, the Smurf who is currently in the lead slams on the brakes, causing a collision. The drivers jump out of their cars and start to run. The Smurfs have noticed Gargamel's horrible machine speeding towards them. They hide in the bushes and watch the wizard destroy their Smurfmobiles. Gargamel removes the pot of stew from the vehicle, and the steamroller stops. The wizard takes a closer look at the wrecked cars and realizes they are empty. Hefty jumps out of the bushes and leads Gargamel to the front of the steamroller. In the meantime, his friends suspend the pot of stew in front of the giant.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.